Here again, clean pocket from the line, clean pocket really. So some plays, because it's the same set and the same front as we had before. They are in a nine technique position. Both edge are in nine technique position. So basically outside, on the outside shoulder of each tackle. And they really do a good job this time. They really drop well. Me, I have a tendency to not go too far behind, so it is good even to eventually, if the pocket does not collapse inside, to even move up, which can be by me few seconds. And here on the coverage, as a safety on the strong safety is a bit slow to help. That looks like cover two man. It's a cover two man. It's a cover two man. The weak side backer stay in spy because Etienne number one is not doing any route, so he's sitting there waiting for an eventual QB run. So it is an under two zone. So the two safeties, they drop back. I think they are not really helpful on this. The three, they really protect the deep, and not even because the strong safety here collapse a little bit. It does not help inside. Why on this play is it making sense? If should this guy here should help inside Griffin. Griffin does not have much help from this gentleman. This gentleman should come here to protect or drop like that. But the point perhaps is afraid of the Titan here. I don't know. This is arguably an issue, but they are not the best safety either, because ratings, zone, and play recognition matter as well. So there is an element of that, but perhaps we don't really know, to be honest. I'm not shocked with 25 to not support inside because he's in deep zone. And 25 actually does a good job. It tries to come, it's just a bit far away. But he's defending nothing on the other end. There is no one here. Here he should come help. Here a good IA, a better IA, let's say, because the IA is good. Let's not say it's crap because it's not. A better IA is a 25 would jump here. Would come here to cut. If that guy catches the ball, he will cut him in two parts. He will really break him. Like bam, boom, voilà. And this guy, we don't really know. Number two, Jenkins, we don't really know. Perhaps I think he should jump inside, but perhaps he's confused a little bit. But here he sees that I throw, and I don't look outside. I look inside. I think number two here make a mistake. He should be here. But before, he see as well, he's a bit confused because he see two guys. I don't know. Interesting. So here I have reset the defense to be in two man. Number one, this formation switches the tight end and the slot wide receiver. And the defense line up with the Mike linebacker on the wide receiver, the slot, and the nickelback on the tight end. So that is first problem. Second problem is still. Still, because I think again, Jenkins is useless on this play again. I think both safeties drop to protect the safety help on two man under. Does not seem to handle well trips formation, especially that set, which has the slot and the wide receiver. Well, here, the root of the wide receiver is just to the flats, so Miles Jack follows. The one who collapsed on this play is Griffin. Griffin collapsed inside. Again, I think he does not dispute the route. If he disputes the route inside, that could be a first way to contain this in man coverage. But the key problem is safety drops to cover the deep zone here. Ignore the beat the post. He's too slow to hear. He does not know, in fact. He has two feet. But I think here he should come to cut here to help Griffin inside, because obviously he does not handle the post. The separation is there. Here Shark is open. On the other side, again, 25, on the other side, 25 drops. We don't really know. I think his behavior is a default behavior. He does not really read the set, because I think it's more coded when you face a spread look rather than a trips look, because we can see that he does not help much. Look, he's covering the deep zone here, but no one attacks it. Eventually, he should move here. Eventually, he could, but he's too far anyway to make a play on Shark. Shark is more on the strong safety, Jenkins to cover. So Wilson, the free safety, he pretty much does not play. He's useless. So Anderson is totally destroyed by Jones on this route, because I think so that should lead to some conclusion when you play defense. If you want to apply a two man under coverage on trip set, you better be aware of these kind of things. So potentially consider to press outside, force. Because if they go inside, there is no protection. The safety will help outside, I think, because it's a default behavior. They don't do a good job to help middle route, but it will be a rubber coverage here. Eventually, we'll do a better job. So, yeah, there are some stuff. So, it's not like each coverage has its strengths and weaknesses. So yeah, we can make doing a practice on offense. We can find out some solution for our defense, because we can see that if we face a trips set, we have to really pay attention if we use a two man under coverage.